Hi, I'm Jennifer.
Hi, I'm Dan.
And we're with Augustine Surgical. So Dan, tell us about the newest feature available on the HotDog Management Controllers.
So Jennifer, the HotDog Temperature Management Controller has a lot of great features, but the newest one that was recently unlocked with a 510K clearance from the FDA is the temperature monitoring and Automode features.
That sounds really cool. So why is it so important to monitor a patient's core temperature?
Well, during under general anesthesia, a patient will actually lose his or her ability to actually regulate their core temperature. And as a result, they're prone to hypothermia. Hypothermia has a lot of negative consequences, such as increased blood loss, higher incidence of infection and cardiac events. And it's important to monitor a patient's core temperature as a result. And HotDog temperature management is ideally suited to helping a patient attain and maintain their core body temperature at a normothermic level.
If it's the standard of care to monitor the core temperature vital sign, why would a clinician want to use this temperature monitoring feature compared to what they're currently using?
Well, the core temperature data can be used to guide clinical decisions during the case, and it can also be used to automatically set the temperatures and regulate the temperatures of the connected devices in what we call Automode. This is actually done using physiological closed loop principles, as well as a number of built-in safety features.
So when is it most useful to use Automode?
Well, because HotDog temperature management is so effective at rewarming with its conductive warming blankets and mattresses, it is very efficient at achieving normothermia. So you're gonna wanna monitor the temperature, potentially turn down the set temperature of the devices as the patient achieves and increasingly raises their core temperature. This is particularly true in longer cases. This is in stark contrast to forced air warming blankets that really struggle to achieve normothermia for the patient during surgery.
So what's needed to get started?
Well, all you need is a temperature probe. We have esophageal rectal as well as esophageal stethoscopes and a proprietary adapter cable that you can connect right to the back of the controller and connects to the probe.
Okay. So can the patient's core temperature be replicated on the anesthesia monitor?
Yeah, actually it's really handy because even though the patient's core temperature is displayed here on the screen, it can also be transmitted to the monitor or the electronic medical record using a cable connected to the back of the controller at a port specifically for that purpose.
Okay. And can this feature be used by controllers already in customer use? So what about our older WC52 controller?
Unfortunately, the WC52 does not have this feature, but the WC71s and 77s that have been on the market for a number of years now are able to utilize this feature, provided you have the probe and the cable.
Okay, great. Thanks, Dan.
Well, you're very welcome. For more information about this feature, please visit our website, hotdogwarming.com, where we have a longer video explaining how to set it up and a lot of written information.
Great, thanks, Dan.